Google Ads, the top traffic source for many website owners out there, and Google Analytics, the widely used analytics solution many of you have installed to get a grasp on your users' behavior. Although these tools alone already provide so much value, putting them together actually can be quite powerful. That's why I've invited ads expert Ilana Wexler from Teach Traffic, her channel is right over there, onto the channel to show us how we can use both of these tools together and use them effectively. Now we got lots to cover, so Ilana, take it away.
Thank you, Julian. Hi there, Ilana here from teachtraffic.com. And in today's video, I'm going to be walking you through how to link your Google Ad account to your Google Analytics account. And what you'll see is just how easy it is to do. Now, before I show you exactly how you do it, you might be wondering, why would you bother? Why would you bother going to the extra step to link your Google Ad account to your Google Analytics account? And really, there's two main reasons why you would do this. The first reason is so that you can observe the behavior of the traffic that has come from Google Ads. So when you start running Google Ad campaigns and sending traffic to your website, when you log into your Google Ad account, what you'll find is they will tell you all about the amount of impressions your ad has had and how many clicks it's had and the click-through rate, etc. But it doesn't tell you any information about when somebody does click to your website, what happens then? Do they view other pages on your site? Do they leave straight away and have therefore bounced? You don't have any idea actually what they do once they get to your site. And as somebody who manages traffic campaigns, you want to really identify the quality of that traffic. If you're paying for someone to come to your website and they leave straight away, well, then it's not very good quality. And personally, I'm a believer in quality over quantity any day of the week. Okay, so by linking those two accounts, when you log into your Google Analytics account, and I'm going to show you in a sec what it looks like, you will be able to observe the behavior of that Google ad traffic. You'll be able to see how many pages they've viewed on your site, how long they spent on your site, the bounce rate, etc. You get a whole bunch of information about that Google ad traffic. And it's a really good way to identify of, are you buying quality traffic? So that's the first and probably the most important and main reason. The second reason why you'd want to link your two accounts is so that you can create some what's called Google Analytics retargeting audiences. Now, this is a little bit of an advanced strategy in Google Ads, but essentially what you're doing is you're creating an audience of people in your Google Analytics account based on various type of behavior of which you choose, and create an audience of those people and pushing that audience into Google Ads. So for example, a classic example of this would be to create an audience of people who did not bounce on your website. So perhaps they spent more than 3 seconds on your site, for example. So create a subset audience of that of those people. Obviously, you'll get less people in that audience, but you know, they're going to be more engaged and more adept to respond well to your retargeting campaign, and create that audience in analytics and push that audience into Google Ads and show those people a retargeting ad through Google Ads. And you can obviously do, you know, it's really limited by your imagination what type of audience you can create. And, you know, I sort of teach lots of different methods to create audiences based in Google Analytics. The classic example is the one that I mentioned of filtering out the people who've bounced. I also sometimes filter out people who spent maybe less than even 10 to 15 seconds on your site. And yes, we get a significant drop in users, but at least the users that I am showing a retargeting audience to are really engaged, and they respond well to our retargeting ads, and the retargeting campaigns then actually do much better. Anyway, so they're the two main reasons why you're going to link your Google Ad account. Now, this video is going to assume that you already have a Google Analytics account installed on your website and that you already have a Google Ad account, not necessarily running ads at the moment. And actually, we recommend you do this step before you even run any campaigns. So let's dive into a Google Ad account. And as you can see here, this account is completely empty and brand new. I've got no campaigns. Now, there's actually two ways that you can link these to these Google Ad and Google Analytics accounts. You can do it within Google Ads or you can do it within Google Analytics. My personal preference is to do it within Google Analytics. So I'm going to navigate to the Google Analytics account for this particular website. And what we're going to do is we are going to go to the admin section down here, and then you'll get to this screen. So you'll see that there's three main panels: account, property, and view. Now, it is worth mentioning that you do need to be logged in with the same email address that you've used for your Google Ad account to your analytics. So there's two, they need to match those email addresses. So if you've got a different email address for your Google Ad account to your analytics account for that property, then you're going to have some linking problems. So the email address needs to be the same. Okay, so then we go to the, as I said, the admin section here, and you're going to look in this middle panel here, and you're going to click on Google Ads linking. Now, obviously, I run a number of Google Ad campaigns, and I help a number of people, so I've got access to a lot of Google Ad accounts, and I've got a manager account, so I could potentially link this analytics property to a number of Google Ad accounts. So I have to choose the right account. When you do this in your own analytics account, you might find that there's only one account there. So don't worry if you see something a little bit different to me. It's just because I have access to so many different ad accounts. So I'm just going to scroll down to find the exact Google Ad account that I want to link to. And here we have it down here. I'm going to click that checkbox and click continue. I'm going to give it a name. That's just the name. It doesn't really matter. I'm going to toggle this to be on all website data, and I'm going to click link accounts. And we've linked the accounts. So then we click done. That's how easy it is. And we have linked our accounts. Now you might be wondering, what's the data going to look like once I've linked my accounts and once I've got some campaigns running? So the good news, I'm going to show you exactly what that looks like. So here I am in a live account. Unfortunately, I've blurred out the sensitive information, but what we can see here is when we go on the left-hand side to acquisition, you'll see there's a Google Ads section, and then we go to campaigns. I'm going to minimize that. And I'm going to scroll down here. Well, first of all, we can see for this particular time frame, the users versus transactions, so their sales. Okay, and we can see here that our campaigns, we spent $2,500. If I just toggle across along here, that's a bit better. We spent about $2,500. We made almost 12, and we can see the different conversion rate, e-commerce conversion rate for each of the specific campaigns. And we can also see the bounce rate, right? So for this smart campaign, we can see it had an 80% bounce rate, which is kind of typical for a smart campaign. But for a classic shopping campaign, we had less than 2% bounce rate, which is excellent. So once again, you can really gauge the performance. Obviously, we're never going to get our bounce rate to be zero. We can see the number of pages per session, the e-commerce conversion rate, and importantly, the revenue, right? Which you can kind of get through Google Ads anyway, but we can obviously get a whole bunch of this type of information, and we can make more informed decisions about the effectiveness of our Google Ads campaign. So there you have it. If you've liked this video, be sure to hit the thumbs up icon and stay tuned for more tutorials on Google Ads. Cheers.
All right. Thanks, Ilana, for this great explanation. Hit that like button if you found this video helpful. And if you want to learn more about everything Google Ads, Facebook Ads, check out Ilana's YouTube channel right over there, where she has more tips, tricks, and tutorials on everything paid traffic. In fact, many other videos are out there, just like this one on YouTube ad targeting, which you should check out. For now, my name is Julian. Happy measuring.